Hello and welcome to the 5 Minute Film Club. You Only Live Twice is the fifth outing for Sean Connery as 00 secret agent James Bond. The film, released at the height of the US-Russian space race in 1967, starts with a bit of a Thunderbirds moment when a US space rocket is eaten by another space rocket. The US blame the Russians and the Russians say they have nothing to do with it. With the UK sitting in the middle trying to avert World War III, they have the idea of killing off James Bond in order for him to go back undercover, as he's become a bit too well known. No idea why that should be.
Well, at least he died on the job. He'd have wanted it this way.
They send him off to Japan to work with the Japanese spy agency head, Tiger Tanaka, after they discover that the mysterious space rocket-eating craft has landed somewhere in Japan. Their investigation leads to Osato Chemicals, where Mr. Osato and Secretary Hilda Brandt are amassed as Spectre agents. Bond tries to get away but is captured by Brandt and tied up in her cabin, where she sort of tortures him before piloting a plane with Bond in the back, and then she lets off a flare and leaves Bond to crash to his death. But of course Bond escapes. Enter Q and his little Nelly, a DIY gyrocopter in a brilliantly fun scene which sees Bond in the machine fight off a load of helicopters that suddenly appear when he flies too close to an island's volcano. Meanwhile, another spaceship is eaten. This time it is a Russian craft, and of course they blame the Americans. I love the idea that both sides think that each side have space rockets that can eat other space rockets. Anyway, all of this leads Bond and Tanaka to discover that actually it's not a volcano at all, but the underground lair of arch villain and head of Spectre, Ernst Stavro Blofeld. And we finally see more of him than just his cat. Blofeld, played by Donald Pleasance, might be calm, but he's deadly, as he likes to feed people to his piranhas. You always know how bad a Bond villain is by how he treats his employees. I have some great memories of watching You Only Live Twice. It's probably the one out of Sean Connery's run as James Bond that I've seen the most. And watching it again for this review just reminded me how much fun it is to watch. After the lackluster Thunderball, this film's pace, at the start at least, is just relentless. And also, in this film we get a new Bond director, and that is Lewis Gilbert. He had just made the 1960s mega hit Alfie, and I think he brings in a renewed sense of energy that Thunderball just lacked. Also, he takes Bond in a new visual direction. There is a stunning helicopter shot of Bond on the rooftops fighting off a mass of attackers, and Gilbert sticks with this single take for ages. So easily he could have just intercut this with close-ups, and I think it shows a level of confidence and skill that we haven't seen before in Bond. Story-wise, what I really like about the start of this film is the fact that James Bond gets to do some actual spy work for a change. We see him breaking into safes and liaising with contacts in Japan, like Henderson, played by future Blofeld Charles Gray, whose death scene is one of those remembered best by Bond fans. The script for the film was written by friend of Ian Fleming and children's author Roald Dahl. Dahl pretty much jettisoned a lot of the story elements of the original novel and added in the space rockets to match the times. In the novel, Bond at the climax goes toe-to-toe with Blofeld in a castle beside a great lake in Japan, but during location scouting they couldn't find any castles to match the story. However, they did find, of course, lots of volcanoes. During this flight over Japan, Bond designer Ken Adam turned to producer Cubby Broccoli and said, "Why don't we make his lair in a volcano?" Cubby asked how much it would cost, to which Adams replied, "About $1 million," and Cubby said, "Well, if you can build it for $1 million, that's fine by me." The resulting set is Adam's finest in the Bond series. The set was absolutely massive. In fact, it was clearly visible for 3 miles away from his Pinewood home. Aside from all the good things that I have to say about You Only Live Twice, there are elements of the film that I take issue with. For example, a lot of the finer details of the plot you just can't pick up on during your first watch. And then we get to the biggest issue of this film, and that is the fact that they decide to make up James Bond as Japanese. Aside from being insensitive, it really doesn't make any sense for the plot. At the start of the film, they kill Bond so he doesn't raise suspicion when he goes around Japan, but he hardly blends in when he gets there. And then when they decide that he's become compromised again, they make him up as Japanese and marry him off only for that not really to make much of a difference to the plot. By the end of the film, the makeup sort of has faded away, and we are left with Sean Connery as Bond for what was going to be the last time. Connery decided to quit the role while filming in Japan. He'd become tired of it, and also the press intrusion into his life had started to scare him. While in a toilet in Japan, he looked up to see a camera shoved up against the window, and became quite rightly incensed. The production had to provide him then with a posse of security guards. As this was supposed to be the end of Sean Connery as James Bond, it's only fitting that they finally pull back the curtain and reveal the man behind the cat. Originally Jan Vrich, a Czech actor, was cast in the role of Blofeld, but director Lewis Gilbert thought he looked too much like Father Christmas and was replaced with British character actor Donald Pleasance after a few days. Pleasance's performance and look as Blofeld is iconic. Without this version of Blofeld, we wouldn't have Mike Myers' pitch-perfect Dr. Evil in the Austin Powers films. Blofeld, in my mind, is like an escaped Nazi officer who, instead of disappearing off to South America, has made his base in Japan. He's a cross between a mad scientist and a monster left over from Hammer Horror. The title song for You Only Live Twice, sung by Nancy Sinatra, is written by regular Bond composer John Barry, and I really think it's one of his best. Although the song I can take or leave, it's Barry's use of it in the film score that is so brilliant. As a finished film, You Only Live Twice might not be as good as the highs of Goldfinger and From Russia With Love, but I think it caps off Sean Connery's Bond with a great sense of style.
About that honeymoon.
Why not? But they'll never let you stay.
But they'll never find us.
Thank you very much for watching my review of You Only Live Twice. You'll have to wait a couple of weeks before I get to On Her Majesty's Secret Service with a new James Bond, George Lazenby. Next week, I'm looking at the 1964 Roger Corman, Edgar Allan Poe film, The Mask of the Red Death. And also Sam Raimi's 1990 comic book film, Darkman, just before I leap back into Spider-Man next month with The Amazing Spider-Man. And of course, I continue my Halloween series with Halloween 4, The Return of Michael Myers. So, if you want to see all those videos, make sure you subscribe to the channel, leave a comment down below if you enjoyed this video on You Only Live Twice, and I'll see you next time. Thank you very much. Goodbye.